If I want it, I'ma have it. Christian Dior. I'm up in all the stores. I'll make a call.
What's up, YouTube? It's Michael Lee, and welcome back to my channel. Today, I'm gonna be doing a video that I've been wanting to do for mad long. I love my school. I have so much pride in my school. I just wanna, do a video of, the truth about UAlbany. I love this school, and I just wanted to tell you guys, my point of view on, what is it really like to be a student at UA. But yeah, so that's basically what I'm gonna be talking about today, and I've been wanting to do this video for a while. When I got accepted, when I got here, there's just been mad videos that people be talking about UA, and, I agree with, some of them, but I disagree with, certain things that people say, and it's just, I'm gonna just sit here and tell you my opinions. This is just what I think. If you disagree, you disagree. So before we get started, make sure you like, comment, and subscribe. And yeah, let's get into this video. So recently I asked my Instagram, I told my Instagram that I was gonna be doing this video, and I was like, ask any questions that you want to know. So I got I got a lot of questions actually, and I'm gonna answer them for you guys. So this is a UAlbany Q&A slash info video slash college update, because I'm gonna be telling you guys a lot about how my college experience was freshman year, I guess. Well, before Corona ruins everything, you know. Basically, what I'm gonna do, I'm gonna just hit on certain points, right? And then at the end of the video, I'm just gonna be answering all the questions that I didn't already address while I'm talking about it. The first thing that I'm gonna talk about is the dorms, because I be getting mad questions about the dorm size, what it's like to live in a dorm. Basically, the dorms are small. I'm gonna just be blunt about that. The dorms are very small. It just depends on where you live. There's four different quads. When you're a freshman or a sophomore, you live on one of the four quads if you live on campus, and the four quads is only for freshmen and sophomores. Basically, the dorms are small. A lot of people say they think that my dorm is very big. They've seen my pictures that I post on Instagram, my dorm tour or whatever, and it looks bigger than your typical college dorm room, and it's really not big. It's dead small. The only reason why I feel like it's so small, this is my room, right? This is my freshman room. Do y'all see this closet? This closet is so small. Now, don't get me wrong, not all rooms are the same. Every single room is different. So I didn't get a small room, but I didn't get a big room. It's not fair the way they do certain things here. And I say this because certain people get blessed with a big room, and certain people get violated with a small, tiny box. Everybody pays the same price for room and board, and some people end up with a huge room, some people end up with a tiny little, how does somebody live like this? Certain closets are bigger than others, certain rooms are bigger than others. That's just how it is. Certain closets are literally double the size of this. But it also depends on the room size. You know, when you have a really small room, they tend to give you a big closet. But when you have a big room, you have a small closet. It's you can't always get everything, you know? And another thing, we have renovated rooms and we have unrenovated rooms. So the renovated rooms, for example, Indian Quad. I live in Indian Tower, and Indian Tower all has these low beds. And you know, when you go to college, you get these high beds where you could put all your stuff under your beds. And Indian Tower has low beds where you could barely put anything under. There's also other suites and other rooms and other dorms, other quads, where the beds are regular, average, typical college dorm beds, you know, where there's high. Literally, I think this is dead the only building with low beds. But I honestly do feel UAlbany dorms are smaller than average college dorm sizes. Some of the ones that are renovated are big. I feel like I don't live in a tiny room, but it's not big, you know. I feel like I live in it's okay, it's manageable. I wish it was bigger because I have so much stuff, but I made it work. I did a dorm tour on my channel, and I posted when I first got here, so if you scroll down on my channel, I'll just leave the link in my description box. I personally have a lot of stuff, so that's probably the only reason why I'm saying the rooms are small. Do y'all see this? A little room is not doing it for me. Next thing that I'm gonna talk about is the education. So basically, this school, it's not hard. It's not oh my gosh, I'm in Harvard. But it is very you need to do your work. Some professors are you know, you always have that one professor that's why are you like this? That's not just at UAlbany though. That's at every school. You're gonna have good professors, you're gonna have bad professors. And I feel like the UAlbany professors, they really do care about you. All right, I'm dragging it. Some of the professors care about you. But if you're in a big lecture class, there's nothing that the professor could really do for you when they have 400 students in one class. And imagine how many classes they have. It's not like high school where your teacher's gonna reach out to you all the time hey, you need to do your work. It's not like that. Y'all already know this. If you in college or you want to go to college, you should really know they're not gonna be on you. You're gonna have people that care about you. Yes, you have college advisors and counselors and stuff, but it's not like high school. The work, it is time consuming, but it's manageable if you don't procrastinate. I'm a bit procrastinator. So I be complaining about my, like, the work that I get, because I get mad work, but so does every other college student. You gotta do what you gotta do. I don't know what the workload is like at other colleges, so I can't really compare it, but I just know that they give you a lot of work. I think the education is really good. I've learned so much, and it's not even the end of my second semester, and I feel like I'm so much more educated than I was when I graduated high school. Now the next thing, I'm gonna talk about the food. It's like, how do I even talk about the food? Like, the food is not good. It's not good. All right, when you first get here as a freshman, you have a meal plan where you get unlimited swipes in a dining hall. And the dining hall, like, they have different options every single day. But they have, like, some things are the same every single day. Like, they always have bagels. They always have waffles. They always have sandwiches. They always have fruits. It's like, they have, like, a lot of the same things every day. But, like, the actual meals change every single day. When you first get here, it might seem like, oh, it's not that bad. Like, I could do this. But if you eat it every single day, like, I know everybody talk about this in their video at college. Like, you eating the same food every single day. It's like, all right, you know, so like the food, it's not that it's like horrible, it's just you get tired of it. And as a freshman, the meal plan that you get like a certain amount of discount dollars where you can eat in the campus center. That food is good as to freshmen. You know, when you're a freshman, you like, oh my god, I want to go to Damien's, I want to go to Halal Shack, I want to go to Fountain Grill, I want to go to Baba's. Like, you want to go to all these food places because you're a freshman, you're so used to being in the dining hall. Going to the CC, it's like, okay, like this is something different. But I feel like when I become a sophomore, I'm gonna get tired of the CC. I'm gonna be like, all right, like I'm tired of dining hall, I'm tired of the CC. So it's not even only about like the food being bad, it's just about you're gonna get tired of it. Some things are horrible though, like just don't eat that. Next thing I'm talking about is money. So this doesn't just go to like UAlbany, this is like college in general. Like, you're gonna need money. What I'm gonna say about UAlbany has a lot of events, right? Like fashion shows, and like every org has events, and all these events be mad expensive. Like, some of them be cheap, you know, like a dance show would be like $5, but then some of like the fashion shows would be like $25, and there'll be like a fashion show like three times in one semester. You're gonna need money for college, like not just for food. You're gonna need money for food. When you go out to party, you're gonna need money for parties. You're gonna need money for Ubers. You're gonna need money for events. Like, these events on campus, like when you think about it, $25 is like, oh, that's not bad. But think about how many events you go to in one semester, you know? And I've been wanting to go to all the events. If you think about it, if I go to all of these events, I'm spending $200 on events for one semester. Not only are you going to the event, you also have to look nice for the event. I'm gonna wanna buy new clothes, pop out, look cute. So that's what I'm saying about money. Like, UAlbany, you definitely do need money if you wanna be lit, if you wanna go to all the events, you wanna be lit at parties. So I advise you to get a cute little job, like either on campus, off campus, whatever. Like, you don't have to slave yourself and work every single day, even though I do it. You're not gonna get the full college experience if you don't wanna pay for anything, you know? You're gonna have to pay for events in order to have fun. This also brings me into the whole like idea of like orgs and like clubs on campus. Now there's mad orgs and there's mad clubs on campus, right? But when I tell you, like, these events be lit, like, I'm sorry, if you go to UA and you disagree, like, you're boring, because you make it what it is. If you feel like everything you do on campus is boring, you're boring. Like, there's something to do every single day on campus. How could you possibly be bored at this school? Like, yo, this school is so big, there's so many people that go here, there's so many things to do, not even just on campus but off campus too. Like, somebody asked me how's life like in Albany. I'm gonna just answer that real quick before I'll get back into the orgs and the clubs, whatever. But like, life off campus is great as well. Like, there's mad stuff to do off campus. People be like, oh, there's nothing to do in Albany. What? There's so many things to do off campus. Like, we have the mall, Crossgates Mall. It's literally two bus stops away. It's mad close. There's mad stuff to do in that mall. There's Dave & Buster's. They have like this arcade thing. I think it's called like Apex. I don't even know. They have the movie theaters. They have like it's not Sky Zone, but it's something like Sky Zone. They have ice skating, roller skating. There's just mad stuff to do around the school in Albany in general. Also, this is the capital of the state. This is the capital of New York. You need to do your research and see what is in this area. And what can I do? How can I have fun? And the thing is, it's so cheap out here. Like, everything be mad cheap. Something like ice skating. Ice skating is so cheap out here. If you go ice skating in the city, you're spending like more than $25. Out here, it's like $3 to skate, $4 to rent a pair of skates. That's $7. People be saying life in Albany is boring. No, it's not. Anyways, back to what I was saying about orgs in the club. There's mad orgs, there's mad clubs. Like, you could literally find an org or a club for anything. And if there's not a club for what you want, you can make one. The events that come with all of these like orgs and clubs is dumb lit. And I feel like in order to really like get the full college experience, you should get involved in school. You know, you shouldn't really just be in your dorm 24/7. You should join a club, you should join an organization, and you're gonna meet more people, which also leads to making more friends. And a lot of people say like it's hard to make friends in college. It is sometimes, but if you stay in your room all day, it's not gonna make it any better, it's not gonna make it any easier. Joining clubs and stuff, it makes it easier to like meet new people, especially as a freshman, because you're brand new to the school. So joining Orienton Club, I 100% recommend it. It's fun, you know? It's really fun to like hang around people that like share the same like interest as you. You know, if you're on the dance team, y'all all dancing, like y'all lit. Like shout out to Nemesis. Like I love my dance team. I'm gonna join these clubs. I'm gonna go to these events. I'm gonna have fun. I'm gonna do all of this. Okay, next thing I'm gonna say, cause I already like kind of like touched on it. I'm gonna talk about making friends. I personally feel like making friends at UAlbany is hard. I don't know if it's just because I'm a shy person and a lot of people do not believe this. I'm dead shy sometimes. You know, when it comes to meeting new people, I'm shy. It's hard making friends at UAlbany only because the school is so big. A lot of people come to the school already knowing people, so they already have like their own cliques. And once people have their cliques, it's like, these are my friends. I don't know how to describe. I mean, it could be easy depending on who you are, how you are as a person or whatever. Like, if you're like very talkative and you're very like, you go up to people, you start conversation, and you're very outgoing, you're not shy, you're just like, hey, what's up? Like, da 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 da. It's not hard to make friends that way. And also, like, there's a lot of things that happen on campus where you meet people and you become friends. So, like, let's say, like, you always going to a party and like there's math that always going to parties and y'all party together like every single weekend. You know, you're gonna eventually be like, oh, like this person seemed lit, like let me hang out with this person, let me see what's up. But I'm gonna say this, you definitely do have to be outgoing when it comes to making friends at college, because people just be like in their own shell and just like you have to like go out your way, be like hey, you know, like let's do this together. You ate at the dining hall, like, oh, you hungry, like let's go here. If you have the same class as somebody, you be like, oh, you study for that test, like we go to the library after class. You have to like put yourself out there and make yourself like available to make friends again. And like I also said, join clubs, join orgs. Yeah, you like tend to make friends with people that you went to orientation with too as well, because like nobody knows each other like at orientation. Another thing, people become friends because they smoke. And I'm gonna just be blunt about this, I don't smoke, but when you siphon and you know you smoke with people, or if you smoke and you see that somebody else smokes, you hit them out and be like, oh, like siph. And that's also how a lot of people become friends on this campus. Like they just siph together and it just becomes a friendship. I feel like if I smoke, I would have way more friends because I would have way more people to siph with. This also goes into being mixy. Now I know like people don't even know what being mixy is. Before I got to this school, when I heard the word mixy, I thought like she always trying to fight, or she always trying to be in drama, or she's mad mixy, you know, she's always want to be in a fight or something. Like that's what mixy is, like you mixy, like, or you trying to fight. That's what I thought mixy was until I got here. Everybody calling each other mixy and I'm like, what the fuck, what's mixy, like what's this? I'm gonna just like give y'all like a little definition of what mixy is at UAlbany. Basically, like, you know, mad people, you popular, you like always trying to, I don't know how to describe the word mixy. Basically, like, you always in a mix, like you always with people, you know, mad people, you always chilling in the CC. Like if you mixy and you always in the CC, like you mixy, like you just always in a mix. Basically that's what mixy is. And being mixy helps you make mad friends. Like if you're mixy and you go to every event and you talk to mad people, you try to meet mad people, that's basically you being mixy. Like you going to every mixy event, you meeting everybody, like talking to everybody, always here, always there, you know, you always seen. Being mixy helps you make friends because you're known and people know you. I got a question and it was like, is being mixy good or bad? So this is all based on personal preference. I personally do not feel like being mixy is bad. I feel like being mixy is actually good. It gives you, like, when you're known in a school, I feel like it's a good thing because it's basically like about popularity. Like if you know mad people and you're mixy and you want to run for, like, let's just say like SA, you want to run for Senate, right? It could be a good thing. I wouldn't say being mixy is bad. I mean, unless you really like fiending, like you're OD and like you always trying to be in a loop, like you not even valid, like you're mad. I feel like being mixy is bad when you try too hard. Okay, this school, UAlbany, SUNY Albany, is like the most drippiest place I've ever been to. Like everybody has mad drip, and it's not even like, oh, you pop out to an event, everybody looks good. No, it's every day go to class Monday through Friday, not even Monday, every day. People are always wearing designer. It doesn't even have to just be designer though, like people just always dressed up looking cute. Mad people at the school can actually dress. Like this school has mad people that could dress, but just because you have designer does not mean you could dress. Like let me just say that right now, like some people that be having designer don't even know how to dress, and it's just like you look stupid. Next thing I'm gonna talk about is homecoming. Now everybody know UAlbany for their homecoming. Like homecoming is where it's at. Like everybody goes to UAlbany for homecoming, whether you go to the school or not. Nobody can even be going to the football game, and that's dead what homecoming is, which is mad funny. Homecoming is just a bunch of people dressed up in mad designer, showing off all their fits, drinking, having fun, going to parties. Like that's dead what homecoming homecoming is about. It's basically like all about your fit and getting lit. That's dead homecoming. I personally do not feel like homecoming is overhyped, but I do feel like you might feel that way if you do not do homecoming the right way. And when I say that, I mean like if you don't have a car for homecoming, it's gonna be like, all right, like that's a drive, because the Uber prices be OD for homecoming weekend, because everybody named moms be at UAlbany for homecoming. The parties that be off campus be mad far. When you go to tailgate, it's lit to have your own car. You playing your own music, you getting lit, you know, you pull up in your car. Who you hang out with, what parties you go to. If you go to a Sherm Wack party, then you're gonna be like, homecoming is trash. Personally, my freshman year, I did homecoming so wrong. Like, I wish I could go back in time and do it all over again. Like, I didn't go to any tailgate. I woke up mad late. Like, it was just, it was bad. I wish somebody would have told me all of this. Like, I wish somebody would tell me what and what not to do for homecoming at UAlbany. I just had to learn for myself. That's how it is for a lot of things at this school. Like, your whole freshman year is gonna be a learning experience. So you're gonna know what and what not to do sophomore year. All right, I'm gonna get into the parties at UAlbany. Basically, when I first thought of like college parties and UAlbany parties, I always thought that they was gonna be on campus. I never knew parties was gonna be downtown UAlbany. You had to take the bus to go to a party. Now, don't get me wrong, there is on-campus parties that's like held in like the campus in a ballroom or whatever, and those probably be dumb lit, but most of the parties are off campus downtown. The party is like, you never know what to expect. 9 times out of 10, they're gonna get shut down. They're gonna charge all the guys at the door, or the girls be getting in for free. If the party is like mad crowded, then they're not even gonna let you in. The parties when you're actually inside, they be dumb crowded. It's mainly house parties that be downtown, and I'm a like party person. I like to get lit, so I find them lit. But some people be like, oh, like it's mad hot. It do be hot. Like, it be mad crowded. It's lit when you could get in a circle and do a little, but if I can't even do that, then it's like, all right, y'all need to pack this up. So another thing about parties, like I said, the cops always shut down everything. Like, it be just getting lit and then the cops want to shut it down. Like, damn, y'all be really on it. Nobody cops is different. Like, they will dead shut down any little thing. But basically, like, you will dead go to like 3 parties in one night because of how many parties get shut down. Everybody following everybody else. Nobody know what they doing. Nobody know where they going. It's just, it be mad funny. Like, sometimes it be lit because everybody just be outside and it just be lit, you know? We outside. Yeah, 9 times out of 10, if you go to a downtown party, you're gonna be like party hopping. Like, you're gonna go to like 3 different houses in one night. All right, so now I'm gonna get into like certain questions that I didn't already answer with all the topics that I already talked about. You actually don't get to choose what building you live in as a freshman, so they just place you on any quad, but you get to choose if you want to live in a tower or a low rise. Once you get into sophomore year, you get to choose exactly where you want to live. Like, and yes, as a freshman, you can choose your roommate. I chose my roommate. You could do like the room surf thing and like find a roommate, whatever. Are AM classes actually that bad? Yes, they are that bad. Like, for me, I am not a morning person. I hate waking up in the morning, especially when I be going to sleep mad late from doing homework the night before. Is Indian really the better freshman quad? Yes. It just depends on who's on what quad. A lot of people say UA is mixy. Do you agree? Yes, I agree. UA is mad mixy. Everybody that go here just is mad mixy. Like, what's the culture like? When I first like committed to UAlbany, the statistics say that like more than half of the school is white. I think it's like 51%. There are like a lot of white people at the school, but there's actually like a lot of diversity at the school. OD, like, there's literally a little bit of everything at this campus, and I like that. I really wanted to go to a school that was very diverse. Somebody said, are there really parties like every single day? There dead is. Most people go to parties Thursday nights, which they call Thirsty Thursdays, because mad people don't be having classes on Fridays. But yeah, most people go to parties Thursdays, Fridays, and Saturdays. Never did he really just say what percent of the school is from the Bronx. Too large of a percentage, okay? Does the weather during the winter bother you? Honestly, it does, because I really do not like the snow. But what can you expect? It's Albany. I'm upstate. Like, I can't really avoid that. It's not that bad. It's not like Buffalo. Like, Buff State and UBuff, I don't know how they do that. Somebody said, y'all really don't got kitchens in the dorms. We dead don't. Like, there's no kitchens at all, unless you're upperclassman, like a junior or senior, whatever. The class sizes, you can actually pick what class sizes you want. Like, some classes are like big lecture classes where it's like 400 people. Some classes are really small where it's like only 20 people. Is it overhyped? No. UAlbany is not overhyped to me. I'm sorry, but it's dead not. Like, I love the school, and it actually exceeded my expectations. So UAP summer, like, that's like a whole nother story for a whole nother video. Like people are asking me about UAP summer, but I don't want to answer that in this video because I honestly wanted to make a separate video for that, like what to expect as an UAP student, whatever. Yeah, I don't really want to go too much into detail, but just know like it's a 5-week summer program and you have to complete it in order to become a student. But yeah, so that's my end of the video. Like, I'm chatting at this point. If you like this video, give it a thumbs up. If this video helped you or informed you about UAlbany, about the school, if you want to go here, if you're coming here, comment down if I helped you, because I want to know. Like, and I'll see you guys in my next video.